It's been quite insightful in the sense that we capture in 2 or 4 years what happened in the U.S. in 10 or 15 years. We didn't have a time when we've been measuring diet when the U.S. didn't snack or didn't drink soft drinks or didn't have exposure to many other things. And the technology of work and leisure and movement even in the home had changed so rapidly before people started to study and collect data on that in the U.S. So China essentially allows the laboratory to look at what happens when people get cars or motorcycles. How does that change their movement? How does that change their risk of obesity? So we've captured kind of a social change that we would like to have studied here, that we need to understand to create new policies to get people healthier, but that we couldn't study here because by the time the questions arose and people were concerned with them, it was too far along to collect baseline data on no movement or people walking and biking and so forth.
I think that we've been incredibly fortunate, I mean, in Barry's great wisdom, setting up this depth and detail of all of the data that we collect, but also with our partnership with China and China CDC. And so when they go into the field, they're actually going into people's homes for about 3 days. And in that time, they're able to really get so much information from them, and then also to be able to do these clinical exams where they collect the blood and the other samples that we're collecting over time.
China's really been a laboratory for many things related to diet change as well as activity change for people across the globe.